was early in the morning, and a stillness filled the garden where he lay. Then the ground shook with power as the angels came and rolled the stone away. All the glory of the living God broke through to the darkness of the tomb. And the love of the Father came and filled every corner of the room. Love was in the room, and new life was born where only death had been. Love was in the room, and death and hell would never reign again. When the glory of the living God broke through to the darkness of the tomb, the earth was filled with his beauty, and love was in the room. I was trapped in sin and weakness, sinking ever deeper day by day. Then the blessed Holy Spirit came to touch my heart and roll the stone away. All the glory of the living God broke through to the darkness of the tomb. And the love of the Father came and filled every corner of my room. Love was in the room, and new life was born where only death had been. Love was in the room, and death and hell would never reign again. Oh no. When the glory of the living God broke through to the darkness of the tomb, the earth was filled with his beauty, and love was in the room. When the glory of the living God broke through to the darkness of the tomb, the earth was filled with his beauty, and love is in the room. Love was in the room. Love was in the room.
Our gracious Heavenly Father, we come to you this morning, God, praising your holy name. We are here, God, because we love you. We're here, God, because we love our church. And God, the reason we love our church is because it preaches your word. No deviation. Lord, we just come today, God, to lift you up. And God, sing praises unto you. Lord, hear our pastor, God, as he brings you the word. And God, we just ask you to bless him. Lord, bless each and every one here today, God. We pray, God, that each and every one will get something, God, from this service today. Lord, maybe it's just about love. Maybe God, there's someone, God, that you just haven't accepted yet. But maybe today, your grace, God, will give us that special feeling towards them, God, and we'll learn to love them. But God, we're supposed to love everyone, regardless. And God, we do. Lord Jesus, I thank you, God, for all that you do. I thank you for the day. And God, I thank you every day, God, for every day that you leave me upon this earth. I know, God, once I leave this earth and go to be with you, Lord, that if I had the opportunity, I'd never come back. But God, I thank you. I thank you so much. God, please bless our pastor today. God, we pray, God, that he'll touch someone's heart. And Lord, they'll come down to this altar, Lord, and confess all their sins to you, Lord, and live a different life. Thank you, Jesus. Lord, we ask these things in your holy name, the name above every name, Jesus Christ. Amen.
Amen.
Love and righteousness.
And all the church said, amen. Praise the Lord. Shake their hands, hug their necks, let them know you're glad to see them in the house of the Lord. Hi, everybody, glad you're with us. And we're so excited here on the last day of November, but we're launching into a great season of Christmas where we will celebrate the birth of our Savior. What a great time. What a blessing today to know that a Savior came and there, born in a Bethlehem in a manger. But this baby would not remain a baby. He would grow up, go to a cross and die and pay the debt of sin for all mankind. We bless his name today. Well, as a matter of fact, that's what we're going to be preaching about today from Psalm 103, about the fact that we have a reason to bless the Lord. Blessing the Lord will bring about a victory in our life and will bring about his mighty presence. I pray today the word will transform your life. Bless the Lord. Oh, my soul and all that is within me, bless his holy name. Thank God he daily loads us with benefits and blessings. He forgives our iniquities. He heals our infirmities today. And he crowns us with loving kindness and tender mercies. Oh, how blessed we are beyond measure in the power and the greatness of our God. We pray today that you'll stay tuned and that your heart will be encouraged and blessed mightily of the Lord. We also want to remind you some great events will be happening around Gethsemane Baptist during the month of December with Christmas and the celebration. And we want you to be a part of those things. So watch your screen for those events, and I know you'll be greatly blessed. We're praying for you, and we'd love for you to come worship with us here at Gethsemane. Our location is at 411 Blue Ridge Street. We're one block off of Lakeside Drive. We're near the main entrance to Lynchburg College. Not hard to find. Also, you can visit us on the internet, ITGM. You can see that address in the corner. Go there. You'll get devotions every day. Great information, and you can see what's happening at Gethsemane Baptist Church. Be a part of God's blessings. And as we go back into the worship, may your heart be encouraged and blessed beyond measure today. So good to have you with us on the In the Garden program, a ministry of the Gethsemane Baptist Church. Be blessed today. That is our prayer.
Of angels sing in exaltation.
God's children said, yeah. Amen. Give the Lord a praise in the house of the living God. He's worthy. Glory to God in the highest. Bless his holy name. You may be seated.
King David was a man that God loved dearly. And David knew God's power in his life. With one small stone, God helped him slay the giant. And with God's help, he ruled with power and might. Oh, but in a time of weakness, David fell. And his fellowship was broken with the Father. Broken and alone, like a child without a home, David cried, "Restore the joy I had with you." restoration. His restoring power is greater than our failures. His love for us is strong. It's never ending. Extended grace and mercy, full and free. We're forgiven. Mistakes that we have made have been forgotten. Somewhere beneath the sea of God's forgetfulness, oh, we can rest in His love and His restoration. When memories of your failure, they seem to haunt you, and Satan says that God is done with you. The victories you once had are fading moments. All hope seems gone. You don't know what to do. Just remember His salvation is eternal, and He does not walk away because you fall. He wants to give you more than you've ever had before, and He longs to hold you close and walk with you. God's love is strong enough to save this world from sin. So surely His restoring power can lift the fallen man. Restoration. His restoring power is greater than our failures. His love for us is strong. It's never ending. Extended grace and mercy, full and free. We're forgiven. Mistakes that we have made have been forgotten. Somewhere beneath the sea of God's forgetfulness, oh, we can rest in His love. Now we're forgiven. Mistakes that we have made have been forgotten. Somewhere beneath the sea of God's forgetfulness, oh, we can rest in His love and His restoration.
You have your Bible, Psalm 103 this morning, talking about the secret to your victory today. And the Word of God tells us in the entirety of this psalm, David is the pen and the paper that parched this down, wrote this down on parchment, that we could receive a blessing from it. And this is all about blessing the Lord. It's a time that we can bless His name and thank Him. For the Word says, "Bless the Lord, O my soul, and all that is within me, bless His holy name. Bless the Lord, O my soul, and forget not all His benefits, who forgiveth all thine iniquities, who healeth all thy diseases, who redeemeth thy life from destruction, who crowneth thee with loving kindness and tender mercies, who satisfieth thy mouth with good things, so that thy youth is renewed like the eagles. The Lord executeth righteousness and judgment for all that are oppressed. He made known His ways unto Moses, His acts unto the children of Israel. The Lord is merciful and gracious, slow to anger, and plenteous in mercy. He will not always chide, neither will He keep His anger forever. He hath not dealt with us after our sins, nor rewarded us according to our iniquities. For as the heavens is high above the earth, so great is his mercy towards them that fear him. As far as the east is from the west, so far hath he removed our transgressions from us. Like a father pitieth his children, so the Lord pitieth them that fear him. For he knoweth our frame, he remembereth that we are dust. As for man, his days are as grass, as a flower of the field, so he flourisheth. But the wind passeth over it, and it is gone, and the place thereof that shall know it no more. But the mercy of the Lord is from everlasting to everlasting upon them that fear him, and his righteousness unto children's children. So to such as keep his covenant, and to those that remember his commandments to do them. The Lord hath prepared his throne in the heavens, and his kingdom ruleth over all. Bless the Lord, ye his angels, that excel in strength, that do his commandments, hearkening unto the voice of his word. Bless ye the Lord, all ye his hosts, ye ministers of his, that do his pleasure. Bless the Lord for his work in all places of his dominion. Bless the Lord, O my soul. Now, this morning, there are certain things worth shouting about today, and certainly our Lord is one of them, isn't he? He is worthy of our praise. He is worthy to be blessed today, and we should be excited in the fact that we are the children of the Most High God, and we have reason today to shout his victory. King David expresses some things that we need to remember in these days in which we're living, in these times that we're going through, and in the places that we are. We're reminded, first, that the name of the Lord is a holy name. We must always remember today, people misuse the name of the Lord. They use it today in matters and ways and factions today that does not honor God but defames the name of God, and also in a way that is cursing or blasphemous towards the Lord. We should always guard carefully how that we use the name of the Lord, and that we use that name and remember that that name is holy. The word holy today means simply that it's set apart for a particular purpose. And I'm glad that we have a name that is above every name, and that is the name of our God. The name of God today should not be used like any other name, simply because this name belongs to the one who sits on high. He is high and lifted up and worshiped and glorified, and today he is worthy of all of our praise. So this one is king above all kings today, and this one is Lord above all lords today. The name of God is a name in which it is a privilege today for the created to even declare he being the creator, and to bless his name in all things, and to speak his name. Just the privilege today to say his name is a blessing today. The name of the Lord, and there are countless names throughout the scriptures and the word of God that today that we can use and apply to our heart and our life. We live in a day which we have stopped thinking about the fact that God, who created us today, and today we are worshiping today his attributes, but understand we're not worshiping the holiness of our God. We don't worship just because of his grace. We don't worship God just because today of his provision towards us. We don't worship God just because today that he loves us. You say, well, preacher, what do we worship him for? We worship God today because he is a holy God, and he is worthy of our worship today. And so therefore today we've got to get in the position of understanding who God is and what he does. It's time we appreciate the amount of himself that he reveals to us. As you open the pages of this Bible today, the word of God, you'll find that God is revealed to us in so many ways today. He shows himself to us. He reveals himself. He exposes his grace, his goodness, his love, all those things today that we're very thankful for. Today we glorify his name over the fact today that we're lavished in the love, and that God showed his love toward us, and that while we were yet sinners, Christ, he died for us today. Moses conversed with God probably more than any other human being that is found in the pages of God's word. Moses was the one, while secured in the cleft of the rock, and there he saw the hinder part of God. Can you imagine the event that happened in that day? And it lit him up like, man, he was like a 1,000-watt fluorescent bulb, because he had seen the hinder part of God that just passed by in a flash. Can you imagine what Moses? Well, it blinded him. It turned his hair as white as cotton, and he was never the same. I'm going to tell you something today. He experienced God. He came into the holy presence of God. And when you experience God and you express today His holiness and you worship Him and you praise Him today, you're never the same today. We didn't come just to have a worship service. We came to have a meeting with God. We've come today to lift up His name and to exalt Him above every name today. Moses was glowing, and understand what he was glowing with was not his glory, but it was the glory of Almighty God. And it wasn't because Moses was so holy today, but it was the God that exposed himself to him that was holy, because he is now in the presence of an awesome God. Do you realize that same God that Moses was in the presence of is the same God that we're in the presence of today? For the Word of God says he changes not. He is the same yesterday, today, and forever. You know, when you think about when you today hear a name, what really courses through your mind? You know, we have names and we think those names have particular meanings in our life or whatever. But in these days in which we're living, people are naming their children after names of insignificance. They name them after great sports heroes. Well, after a while, in a blown out knee or a broken arm or whatever happened to them, not to mention, excuse me, a little aging process, that hero fades off the scene. They named them after movie stars. I haven't found a movie star I'd want to be named after anyway. You say, weren't you named after Charlton Heston? No way. I don't even know, you know, my parents even knew who Charlton Heston was when I came along. Amen. But the fact is, we name our children after great people today instead of naming them after our great God or the great names that are contained in His book. And so Proverbs 22:1 says, a good name is rather to be chosen than great riches today. The Bible says that if you have a good name, if you have a name that is a trustworthy name, if you have a name of character today, there's a name today that will bring a blessing. And today God will bring a blessing to your name when you honor the name of the Lord, won't He? Amen. What do you think about when you hear the name God? I mean, we think about, well, this great God sits in heaven upon the throne, created the heavens and the earth, and He's in charge of all things. But really today, apart from all those particular things that we're automatically gravitated towards, what do you think of when you think about the name of God? Well, names today define character. And today, God has character. And the neat thing about His character is He wants to today place that character within you and I. He wants to use that character in our life and to develop us that we are more like Him. People in the Bible were named by what they had basically done. You look at their names, it transferred into a particular act or something that they accomplished. Eve was the mother of all the living today. Abraham was named Abraham because he was the father of many nations. Then we look at the name of Jacob today, who was born clutching the heel of Esau, and his name was called Surplanter or Deceiver. But later, God would change his name. And understand this, he would change the encounter of his name, because Jacob would encounter God in a wrestling match where God changed not so much his name, but God changed his character. And so now he changed his character, and this name now becomes the name of Israel. And so therefore today, how did all this happen? Well, God touched him. And I'm going to tell you, when God touches your life, he'll change you. He'll change your outlook. He'll change everything about you today in your life. He'll change today your heart, your spirit. He'll change your destination of where you're going. And today, I'm glad that God's a God of change today. Amen. Change today that will birth you out of the clutches of Satan and out of the bowels of hell, and that will birth you into the family of Almighty God and name you as a child of the King. Hallelujah today. You know, when you encounter God, God just doesn't change your name. Listen, He changes your heart. He changes your life. He changes your character. But I'm also glad there's a new name written down in glory. And as the old songwriter wrote, I'm glad it's mine. I'm glad today I have a name, and I'm glad God knows me, the Word of God says, by name. And He has written my name in heaven, and beside my name I'm glad I've been paid for in full by the blood of the Lamb of God, redeemed and a child of the King. Hallelujah today. When God touches you, I'm telling you, you're never the same. He'll do a mighty work in your life. In Psalm 103, David let us know this is not a fleshly or a carnal manifestation of worship. Understand this. This is something that comes from deep within the soul of King David. This is something that God has wrought in him today. David said this, "Bless the Lord, O my soul, and all that is within me, bless his holy name." His name is worthy of praise, isn't it? I said his name is worthy of praise, isn't it? Amen. David was claiming, praise the Lord. He is worthy. That name above every name. David was saying, when I give God praise, I give it to him from the very depths of my being. It just doesn't come from the flesh. It comes from the soul and the spirit. It comes from the heart. It comes because I do love the Lord and I praise his name. In this day that we're living, so many churches are saying, well, you know, when it comes to church, it's a serious place. So the churches are dead, dried up, and they perceive that seriousness. That's not seriousness. That's deadness. And anything that's dead needs to be taken out and buried, right? Amen. I agree today in one sense because every Sunday, people come into this church with serious needs, problems, and need serious answers. And so, yes, it is in one sense a serious place. People are facing serious consequences of their sin, and they need today a serious forgiveness of their sins that only God can provide, and they need a serious redemption that only Jesus today can give. And to blot out our transgressions and to remove our iniquities today and to remove every sin stain and to put us in a right standing before Almighty God today. The church is a place where they're seriously hurting people today that are going through struggles in life, through the assaults of life today, through all the situations that Satan is beating up on people and pulling them down to the depths of discouragement and defeat. You know what? These people need serious comfort. And folks, should be the place where you can find the serious help of God, the serious hope of God, the serious comfort of God, and that every need can be met in your life because you're in the presence of a holy God. Those who are seriously helpless today, they need serious help. And I'm glad that we've got a God that supplies that today. There's only one way these serious matters can be resolved. And that's when today we get into a position of coming before God in serious praise today. You know, you can bring your struggles and your troubles to the Lord. You can bring your heartaches and your difficulties. You can bring your griefs and all your hurts of life. But I'm going to tell you something today. Those things God will hear and God will change. But it's one thing today that gains and gets God's attention quicker than anything else. It's when his people come before his holiness and his presence and bless his name. And today come in a serious mode of worship today. There's nothing wrong with lifting up the hands or giving the shout unto the Lord. For our God is a worthy God. Some of you are going to be surprised when you get to heaven. You think it's going to be a quiet, serene place? I'm going to tell you what it's going to be. It's going to be a place of praise and exhortation and glory. And there's not going to be too many quiet moments in heaven. For we're going to be seeing him face to face and beholding the glory of our God. And we're going to have reason to shout that victory, to give praise to our God, for he is worthy. Amen. It's something about praise. David said in Psalm 150, "Let everything that hath breath praise the Lord. Praise ye the Lord." It gets personal here, doesn't it? God's saying you need to praise him. Well, I'm going to praise him when I get past the struggles and the troubles and the sicknesses and the pains and the hurts and everything else that I'm going through in life. No, it's time to praise the Lord right now. It's time the people of God start giving God glory and honor for who he is today, for what he has done for you, how he's prepared a place for you. Jesus said, "Let not your heart be troubled. You believe in God, believe also in me. In my Father's house are many mansions." You know what? That's something to praise God over today. God commended his love toward us, and that while we were yet sinners, Christ died for us. That's something to praise God over. God says, "I'll cast out your sins. I'll cast them as far as the east is from the west," as we read earlier this morning. He today said, this is something to praise God over. This is the God who will heal your diseases. This is the God that will crown you with loving kindness and tender mercies. This is the God that will forgive everything that was against you. I think it's time the people of God rise up and bless the name of the Lord and praise His name, for He is worthy to be praised in the house of the living God. For He and He alone has done great and mighty and marvelous things. Oh, great is our God, and may His name be exalted above every name. Bless the Lord. Bless His holy name. Bless the Lord. Amen. See, today, when you demonstrate in the courts of heaven that you're not ashamed to raise your hands and to lift up and to raise your voice today, that He and He alone is greatly to be praised. What happens is, when you get that serious about getting into the presence of God, God gets real serious about helping you. Amen. You cannot go to God in a flippant attitude. You can't just cruise into heaven's gates when you're going through a struggle. Man, you need to camp out there. Hallelujah. What better place to be than in the presence of a mighty God? Amen. When it comes to worldly events, we lose all sense of seriousness. Some of you did this past Friday night. I saw some of you post. I mean, y'all just came unglued over a football game, right? That's all right. Nothing wrong with that. Some of you come unglued over activities and events, sporting events and other things that happen. That's all right. But I'm going to tell you something. I come unglued when I'm in the presence of a mighty God who is worthy of praise. Hallelujah. That's something to praise God over. That's something, because, see, these events all pass, but the things of God remain. What God has worked in us today doesn't just pass away. It's a remaining. The essence of His presence continues to live in our presence today. And we can get that aroma of God into our nostrils and down into the depths of our soul. And we can feel His hand upon our shoulder. And we can hear His voice that says, "Peace be still." And we know we've been in the presence of a mighty and glorious God, for He is worthy. Amen. Praise God. Praise the Lord. When it comes to the fact today, and we realize the issues that we face in our life, we've got to lift up our voice and declare, "Great is the Lord, for He is greatly to be praised." Amen. When you bless the name of the Lord, you're using it for the highest and the holiest purpose. Amen. We know in the Bible, He is called Jehovah. What a name. Oh, what a mighty name. There are names that describe the character of God. They don't get nervous and think, "Oh my God, He's going to preach through all those names in the Bible." No, I'm not going to do that. In Psalms, David said, "Oh God," I like this part, "my God." It gets personal. In the Hebrew, it's saying, "El Shaddai, you are Elohim." Now you say, "Preacher, what are you saying?" I'm speaking to you what the Word says. El Shaddai today is one name for God, meaning that He is an all-sufficient God. And Elohim is another name for God, meaning He's everything. Hallelujah. So David was saying, the all-sufficient God is everything, simply when he just declared and said, "Oh God, my God." Hallelujah. The God of sufficiency now becomes personal and becomes our God. So David was saying, in all the sufficiency of God, He is everything. Oh, is He everything to you today? Oh, today, is he what life is really all about today? We have struggles and trials in life. But you know, amidst all that, those things will pass away. But you see through the haze of life and the difficulties. And on the other side is a God who's always there. Amen. A God you can trust in. David was saying, I need not look any further. I just need to look to God and thank Him. I just need to look to God and praise Him. When we read the Word of God, we reveal, or is revealed to us, the very character of our God today. When we speak the name of God, we invoke today the character of God into our lives. Now all of a sudden, what is out there is coming to be a personal part of us today. I like the way James put it. This is an awesome scripture. I use it often. James 1:17, every good gift and every perfect gift is from above and cometh down from the Father of lights. And listen to this part. With whom is no variableness, neither shadow of turning. They measured time in that day by the shadow of the sun. They could tell what time of day it is simply by the shadow that it was casting. So this same God, and understand this, this same God is the same yesterday, today, and forever. This same God who was there for David is this same God who's here for us today. This same God who defeated the giant will defeat every giant that you face in life today. Amen. This same God who fed over 5,000 today, he'll feed you. Amen. This same God who sent his son and turned hospitals into healings and funeral processions into parties and still possesses the power today to turn every problem that you've got into a possibility. For with God, all things are possible. Amen. For he is God. And you know what's so neat about him? He'll do it again and again and again and again. Thank God, there's nothing too hard for our God. Amen. When you speak the name of God, it's like you're picking the lock that opens the very treasures of heaven. Amen. In the name of Jesus. It's by his name that we gain access into the throne room. The name Jehovah Jireh is the name of provision today. God not only sees your need, but he meets your need. And so the name Jehovah Jireh is associated, we know, with Abraham, Isaac, when he took him to Mount Moriah. And there, he, under the instruction of God, he was going to offer his son up as a sacrifice. Isaac was willing to submit to what his father asked him to do. When Isaac said, "Where's the sacrifice?" What did Abraham say? "God will provide." Amen. Jehovah will provide. Folks, today, when you're facing needs, the same Jehovah that provided for Isaac and Abraham is the same Jehovah that will provide for you. Amen. He'll meet your every need according to his riches and glory by Christ Jesus our Lord. And so Abraham believed in a God who could see and meet the need. I'm telling you today, listen what? Listen to me. I know today many are depending upon government processes and programs to try to get them through. I hope you're not, because I'm going to tell you what it's going to bring you to. It's going to bring you to a dead-end street. But if you put your trust in the Lord, some trust in chariots, some trust in horses. But he said, "I will trust in the name of the Lord my God." Amen. Folks, let me tell you, God can see what your need is, and God can supply that need today. Years later, another willing son walked up a hillside. He went to a place that was called Calvary, Mount Calvary. This time, there was no ram that would be caught in a thicket. This same God who oversaw Abraham and Isaac that night was the same God watching from heaven as his son Jesus would die on the cross and bear the sins of all mankind. Jehovah Jireh sees the need of every person in this room, in this sanctuary today. He sees every need in your heart, in your life. Whether people know what your needs are or not, he knows what they are. He sees the needs of a broken heart. He sees the needs of a sin-stained heart. He sees the need of those who are physically sick. He sees the need of those who are hurting, bruised, and battered, and beaten today. He sees the need of those who are struggling in life and trying to make the ends meet today. Because he sees your need now, he sent his son to the cross then to take care of that need. And I'm glad today, Calvary has a complete cure for everything in your life. It'll meet every need that you'll ever face. To hang suspended on Calvary's cross between heaven and earth, and then to declare, "Father, it is finished." Amen. All you need was met by God's divine grace. And in the Bible, he is not only called Jehovah Jireh, that's supplier of every need, but he's also called Jehovah Tsidkenu. This name means that today, he is our righteousness. Hallelujah. See, you're not going to have any righteousness if you don't have him. This means today, when he says that he is our righteousness, I especially like this. He is now then our covering. He covers us in his righteousness. Hallelujah. What does a robe do? It covers you, doesn't it? Well, hallelujah, you've got a robe on that you don't even see, but it was given by God, and it's called a robe of righteousness. Hallelujah. Our flesh today is a rotten thing today, and we all have been little devils in shoes throughout our life, haven't we? We've all failed. We've all missed the mark. How we behave, understand today, God, thank the Lord that He will birth a conscience in us to show us what is right and what is wrong. So how does God deal with our flesh? He being such a holy and glorious God, God sends His Son to be our righteousness. Amen today. When God sees us, He doesn't see you. He sees His Son covering you with His righteousness. Amen. When we are wrapped today in life in the scarlet stains of sin, He wraps around us and blots out our transgressions and removes our iniquities and then wraps us in His robe of righteousness. Amen. We now have a covering today that God can look upon us with. Hallelujah. You remember when He died on the cross, God couldn't even look at His Son? That was because He was bearing the sins of all mankind. Jesus had on Him our sins. But thank God today, now He sees us through the blood that was sacrificed at Calvary, that today we can walk in newness of life and that we today can say, I'm righteous by the blood of Jesus Christ. Amen. It becomes our covering. I'm covered today. You are covered by this righteousness today. He is the God today who lifts us up. Then there's another name, and as I'm almost through, there's another name that He has called Jehovah Makedeshim or Jehovah Makedesh. This means the Lord, our holiness, or sanctification. So today, He is the God who extracted us. To extract means to remove, doesn't it? Amen. Hallelujah. He snatches us out of what we used to be and brings us into who we are. He takes everything that was against us and extracts or pulls that out. And thank God, you know what? He does that and puts us apart in sanctification that we can walk in the holiness of our God today, that we can be something different to the glory of God. Amen. He didn't give you today a remodeled life. He gave you a new life. Amen. He didn't do a makeover on you. He gave you a brand new life, a brand new start, a brand new heart, a brand new destiny, a brand new eternity, and He's giving you a brand new reason to live. And we today, listen, you can't encounter God and be who you are today and to be used of Him if you're not using today the power of God and to bless His name in your life. All the names of God, Jehovah, Rapha, Shama, Nissi, Shalom, Rohi, represent who God is. And God wants this in your life today. And we come before these names, we come into the mighty presence of our God. We don't deserve today to talk to Him, but I'm glad He made a way so we can talk to Him. Amen. Amen. The only way that we can talk to God today is become, and we've got to come the right way. Jesus said, I am the way, I am the truth, I am the life. No man cometh unto the Father but by me. We can access this place where He is at, and He will meet us there. Oh, folks, they only God can make every problem out of every person in a better condition. Maybe you're sitting here today and you got problems in your life. You know, David experienced God. And my question today to you is this, have you? Have you experienced this God, this mighty God of the Bible that tells us of the power and the possession and all the greatness that He is and that we can receive into our heart and our life? Have you experienced Him today? Well, preacher, I'm saved. You know, it's more to it than just being saved. It's more to it than just being saved. Salvation secures you. But I'm going to tell you, sanctification put you in a position where God can use you. Amen. He's looking for people who want sanctification. He's looking for people who want to bless His name. He's looking for people who want to live for Him today. David had his needs met. David had his burdens lifted. David had his life changed. Have you? Have you been changed today? And are you living this change that God has wrought in you today? When David went through the battles, God showed David how that he could have the peace of God that would surpass all understanding. When David was in sin, God showed David how he could experience His grace. For he cried out and God forgave him. Isn't that amazing? That in a cry of repentance, God hears our cry. And as John sung this morning, there's restoration. Amen. When David faced a giant, God showed David how he could be his banner of victory. That's Jehovah Nissi. Amen. When David went through the heartaches, God showed him how he could be the Lord his shepherd and shall not want. See, there's no name like the name of God. Amen. David said, Forget not God's benefits. We don't deserve them, but I'm sure glad he gives them. Amen. When you remember what God has done, I'm going to tell you what's going to happen to you. You won't find it so hard to then praise the Lord. When you remember how he came and condescended and came down from the portals of glory and died on a cross and bore your sins and carried your stains of sin and your sorrows and your sicknesses and your trials and your heartaches and your heartbreaks and everything else that is against you, you realize this today. This God today, he's the one that made all that possible, that we can have forgiveness and grace and help and love and everything that we needed in life. It all comes from our God. I believe it's time the people of God rise up and praise the Lord for how great he is today. So David says, forget not his benefits. What benefits are we not to forget? The benefits of God forgives today. Amen. You know, that is the cure-all that our nation needs right now. It's not changes in political patterns and programs. It's not who goes out and who comes in. What our nation needs is an old-fashioned dose of God's forgiveness. If my people, which are called by my name, shall humble themselves and pray and seek my face and turn from their wicked ways, he said, I'll hear from heaven. And what's the first thing that he does? He says, I'll forgive their sins. Amen. Not only that, but our God still heals. Amen. He's still a healing God. Some of you sitting here today and you got physical infirmity today. I'm telling you, he's a healer. We got many that's out because of sickness today, in hospitals, going through pains in their life. Today, who is that helper? The Lord is our helper. He is our healer. Hallelujah. With his stripes we're healed. Not only that, but he crowns us today with being champions for Christ. Loving kindness and tender mercies. You know what God's saying? You're a champion in Christ. And then fourthly, God satisfies. You can chase this world from the four corners and you will not find satisfaction. But man, when you look to God, there's all the satisfaction you'll ever need. Our God is not a God of just enough. Our God is a God of more than enough today. I implore you and I encourage you and behoove you today. Come today to this God. And whatever you're facing today in life, I'm here to assure you, according as his word has said, he will meet your every need today. We have a God whose name is awesome. We have a God whose name is holy. And today, he is our secret to victory. If you need a victory today, no matter what you're facing, spiritually, physically, or emotionally, God will meet that need. Praise the Lord. Father, thank you today for your mighty presence. Thank you that you're such a God that you would do all these things. Oh, we bless you this morning. We worship you. We adore you. We realize how great our God is. Would you pour out your mercy on us today? As we stand to our feet, I know today this congregation, their needs in their life, their burdens in their heart, and there's today things that they need today God's help in. I pray that you'll lift their burdens and encourage their heart and meet their need today. Pour out your grace. Pour out your sweet spirit. Be honored and be glorified today in this time of invitation. May the Spirit of the Lord have his way here today. And we will bless your name and we will honor your name and we will glorify your name. For you are worthy to be praised in Jesus' name. If you've got a need, he's got a solution. Will you come today?